This is Linno Cave, located in Pa'an, Myanmar.
We have identified this location because there's a number of cave systems here, all in limestone karsts. At the cave sites, you have bats.
Linno, which literally means bat in Burmese, is the home to more than 500,000 bats that emerge each night at dusk in a most dazzling display. Visitors from all over the world come here to catch a glimpse of this incredible spectacle. Linno Cave is also a sacred Buddhist shrine and serves as a pilgrimage site for many people of Myanmar. The cave also attracts many community members for another reason: bat feces, more commonly known as guano. For at least three generations, a single family has been collecting guano from this cave to sell throughout the country for use as fertilizer, much like how cow manure is used in other parts of the world. You can see people walk through the caves barefoot to collect guano with their bare hands and introduce the guano to farms all over Myanmar for livestock and vegetable growth. These practices raise many concerns to us as wildlife veterinarians because of the viruses that may be transmitted from bats to humans, like rabies and Ebola. We at the Smithsonian's Global Health Program are interested in these interfaces between bats and humans because it can tell us a lot about emerging infectious diseases and how they move between species. This makes Linno Cave a perfect research site for us as we try to better understand these infectious disease risks. Before dusk, we set up nets to catch about 100 bats as they depart from the cave. Next, our team of trained Myanmar veterinarians and animal handlers get to work. We identify the species, weigh, collect blood samples, and swab each bat before releasing them, so we can test them for zoonotic viral diseases they may be carrying. We also collect similar biological samples from people and livestock living near these bats to evaluate for the very same viruses. Already, our teams have discovered new forms of coronaviruses that were previously unknown to Myanmar bat populations. We can provide this information to the government of Myanmar and offer guidance on policy development and community education that is both respectful of the Myanmar culture and reduces risks for disease transmission. We believe this will ultimately keep bats safe, as well as the people that depend on them.